Ironized Yeast presents Lights Out, Everybody. Lights Out brings you stories of the supernatural and the supernormal, dramatizing the fantasies and the mysteries of the unknown. We tell you this frankly, so if you wish to avoid the excitement and tension of these imaginative plays, we urge you calmly but sincerely to turn off your radio now.
This is Arch Obler. House guests in the days before rationing, and if they didn't wear out their welcome, were an interesting part of our social lives. But tonight we bring you a story of a most unpleasant and unexpected guest who came to visit Lord Marley.
And now? Lights out. Everybody.
Waiting. Who does the man think we are, I'm asking?
It's like I says to you before we got in here. Try to do a man like his lordship a favor and you'll get it in the neck. That's what I said, and you remember.
Well, I'll give him 5 more minutes to do us the honor, and then it's off I am. I want to look at my nets before the tide changes, that I do. Oh, well, all I'm after is to warn him. Then me duty's done.
It's wasting time. He won't believe you. You mark my words.
Won't believe me and me almost losing my boat to the thing?
His lordship will say it was the tide.
Now, you listen to me, Joey. I've been fishing in these waters here for more years than you got brains in your head. And I'm telling you it was a...
It's his lordship.
Boy, looks to be in a blinking temper now, don't he?
Well, what is it?
If it pleases your lordship, my name is Sam Marler.
I know who you are. You're the fellow I caught poaching rabbits last
night. Now, wait a minute. You didn't catch me poaching nothing. It's an honest fisherman I am, I'll have you know.
Oh, honest, are you? Well, let me tell you, I never forget a face. And if yours isn't the face of the rogue, then
Rogue, is it? Yeah, that Joey calls me the rogue.
Yeah, fine one he is to be talking.
Why, you impudent scoundrels. Out of my house. Out of my house.
But, your lordship, we want to tell you...
You tell me nothing, you thieving rascal.
Oh, it's thieving now, is it? For 2 pence, lordship or no lordship, I'd bash that nose of yours so flat it'd look like a flounder.
Get out of here. Oh, get out, I say.
What is the matter?
These scoundrels.
We're not scoundrels, you old coot, you.
Yeah, we was only trying to warn him that he's...
Not another word. Out. Out, I say.
Come on, Sam. Let's get out of here.
Get out of here.
Stop
get out.
He
get
calls
out.
Himself a visa gentleman. I'm
get out, I say.
Victoria.
And if you dare trespass on my property again, I'll have the law on your thieving necks. The both of you.
There's no need to shout, Charles.
Why?
They're gone.
The infernal rascals.
But I don't understand. They spoke of coming here to warn you.
Warn me? Nonsense. Some infernal scheme that I didn't even give them a chance to reveal. Loafers. Spoiled by the government dole.
But I know those men. Why, they're from the village. Good, honest fishermen.
Honest, no good, not one of them. And if they keep up their infernal impudence, this community is going to lose my trade. You can depend on that. We'll never spend another season here. Not if I have anything to say about it. Confounded rascals warning me.
All right. We'll drop the entire matter right now. What I can't understand is where's that guest of yours?
Hmm?
You said he'd be here by 10 o'clock. Look, it's almost noon.
Yes, My guess. Yeah, true.
What is it, Charles?
Didn't I tell you?
Tell me what, dear?
My guest, it's not a man.
No?
Madeline Kay. You've heard of her?
Madeline Kay? No, I'm afraid not. Who is she?
It's a matter of business. I couldn't arrange to be in the office, you know, because of our little outing, so I asked Miss Kay to come here. Pay frightfully large fees, these Americans, you know.
American? Won't you please tell me who she is, Charles?
Why, surely you know her, the cinema star.
Oh. Oh, the big blonde wench we saw in that Bang Bang Gangster picture.
Oh, now, don't talk like that. I forbid it.
But the picture was definitely a Bang Bang Gangster picture, my dear Charles. Why, I remember distinctly. At least seven of the gangmen, as the Americans say, bit the dust.
You have the most outrageous sense of humor. I'm speaking of the woman, my client.
Oh, you mean she isn't a blonde wench?
Oh, really, my dear, your choice of words is sometimes most inappropriate. The woman is definitely an artist, and my client.
Oh, yes, of course. But was it necessary to have her come here?
Why not?
Well, this is our home.
But I told you it's most important that she consult me. Her financial affairs, you know.
No, I don't
but
know.
But I'm trying to tell you. Oh, great Scott, Jane. You're not going to be difficult just because I invited a client out here. Confounded silly suspicions.
Now, just a moment, Charles. I have no suspicions.
Well, your attitude.
And I have no attitude. You've invited this woman here on business, and I assure you I'll do everything in my power to make her stay as pleasant as possible. Will she be here for dinner?
to tell you the truth,
Weekend?
Fortnight. You know how those Americans are, pushing.
Fortnight. Very well, Charles. I'll go and tell Jenkins that he should...
Charles, here I am.
Apparently, your guest has already arrived, Charles. Mm-hmm. You'd better go out and welcome her.
Yes, of course. You coming along?
Of course.
Careful of that luggage, you idiot. If you scratch it, I'll have you repaired.
Did you say for a fortnight, Charles? She has enough luggage piled up in the tonneau of that roadster for a permanent invasion.
Will she,
Charles. Oh, Charles, how nice. You've come out to your doorstep to welcome me just like a feudal knight or something.
Well, by George, Madeline, it's good to see you.
Madeline?
You said something?
No.
Yes, Madeline. This is Lady Jane.
How do you do?
How do you do? Charles, tell me, what do you think of my new car? It's nice, isn't it? You see, I did take your advice.
You must be tired after your trip, Miss Kay. The roads aren't any too good.
Tired? I'm never tired, am I, Charles? You ought to know. Tried to walk my feet off around the deck, but I wore you down, didn't I?
Oh, you met on shipboard during Charles' trip to America?
Madeline, you must be tired. A rest before tea, perhaps?
Rest? With all that beautiful ocean right there at the end of the lawn? I should say not.
Swim?
Just what I need. Charles, why don't you get out one of your little boats and take me out there in the middle of that blue water so I can take a dip?
Well, that is to say...
Of course you'll do as Miss Kay asks, Charles. Get out the skiff while I show her to her room. I'm sure she'll want to change before bathing.
Oh, yes. I always use a bathing suit while the sun's shining. Run along, Charles, and get the boat out. You and I have all sorts of talking to do, haven't we, darling?
Yes, of course.
This way, Miss Kay. Jenkins has already taken your things up. You'll just follow me.
Sure, why not? The last place I saw stairs like these was on a set in Hollywood. I've always wanted a place like this.
It's very pleasant here during the summer months. Breeze coming from over the bay all the time. It's really quite nice.
Plenty nice.
Right in here, Miss Kay.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
This is the afternoon off for the maids. I'm sorry there's none here to help you. But by the time you get back from your swim, I'm sure one of them will be back.
Oh, it's all right. I've got a bathing suit right in this case here. I think I can get in myself if I hold my breath.
I did want to talk to you.
Talk? Go right ahead.
No. You want to dress?
Oh, stick around. We're all girls together. What's on your mind?
You are very pretty.
You're not as old as I thought you'd be.
You met my husband for the first time on the boat coming back to England.
Blasted blankety catches of all the rotten luggage. There, that does it. Now where's that doggone suit?
You did meet Charles for the first time on the boat, didn't you?
Yes, of course. Oh, am I putting it on in the wrong places?
Will your business keep you in England very long?
Long? I should hope.
Why have you come here, Miss Kay? Charles invited me. Didn't you know?
Why have you come here?
What you mean is, madam, are your intentions strictly honorable? I played a part like that once in stock, and was I lost? Terrible.
Why don't you answer me directly?
Okay, why not? What have I got to lose? Even if you pass along what I say to Charles, he won't believe you. He's a gentleman. Or, is he?
Tell me.
What is there to tell? You guessed it. Like a man, Charles thought you wouldn't, but I knew you would.
It's been going on ever since he met you.
You catch on fast, don't you?
You are cold.
Sister, when you've been around the way I have, you get to know all the answers. And you make up a couple of new ones, too.
But Charles, over 20 years older than you.
And with $20 million more dollars than me.
But you're wealthy.
Press agent stuff. I'm on the skids as far as Hollywood's concerned.
I beg your pardon.
Skids, you know, a one-way street leading down.
Oh.
Yeah. I wouldn't talk like this to my own sister, but as long as you and me got our hair down, what's the difference? The truth is, I'm just about washed up in pictures. Not that I can't act circles around many of those little... they got out there, but it's just that... Well, I was way up there, now I'm on my way down. And that's that. So
you met Charles on shipboard and fell in love with him.
Love?
You laugh?
Well, I'm sure not crying. But I am going to marry him.
You what?
I said I'm going to marry him.
My husband?
He won't be long.
You either have a poor idea of humor or you're absolutely insane.
No, I suppose you'll pull the line about my husband loves me. He'll never leave me.
He won't leave me.
No.
I know, Charles. There have been others.
But he never invited any of those others to his home now, did he? But he did invite me. And I'll stay here as long as I please. And in the end, I won't be the one to go.
Why do you say such horrible things?
Not so sure of yourself anymore, are you, Lady Jane? They never were as pretty as I am before, were they? And they never knew their way around the way I do now, did they?
You'll go. I won't permit you to stay.
Oh, really?
Charles wouldn't dare.
Oh, already. Come on in.
Well, what a charming, charming picture you made.
Yes, I think so, too.
Charles, could I speak to you alone?
No,
I...
no, not now, Jane. I want to take Madeline for a sail before the wind changes. Come, Madeline.
Right with you, dear. See you later, Jane.
Better take my arm, Madeline.
These old steps, quite steep, you know. After all, I wouldn't want anything so happy, so calm.
And in the end, I won't be the one to go.
Why do you say such horrible things?
Not so sure of yourself anymore, are you, Lady Jane? They never were as pretty as I am before, were they? And they never knew their way around the way I do now, did they?
You'll go. I won't permit you to stay.
Oh, really?
Charles wouldn't dare.
Oh, already. Come on in.
Well, what a charming, charming picture you made.
Yes, I think so, too.
Charles, could I speak to you alone?
No,
I...
not now, Jane. I want to take Madeline for a sail before the wind changes. Come, Madeline.
Right with you, dear. See you later, Jane.
Better take my arm, Madeline. These old steps, quite steep, you know. After all, I wouldn't want anything so happy to so calm.
Oh, Charles.
There he goes, Sam.
I see.
But we ought to warn him.
I tried. You saw what I got. Fair booted me out of the place.
Yeah, he's got his lady with him in the boat.
His lady? Where's your eyes? That ain't her ladyship. Her ladyship's a lady. She wouldn't be wearing look like that. Yellow and not enough of it to... Oh, let him sail out there. Why should I warn the likes of them? No, thank you. I'll not waste a breath warning him or her. Not a breath.
Madeline.
Now, Charles, steer the boat.
I'd give anything.
Anything?
Name it.
Not now. Ooh.
What's the matter?
That wind. Where did it come from?
By George. The sun has gone down.
No clouds, yet no sun. What kind of a place is this, anyway?
Yes, it is strange.
I thought I'd go swimming. Oh, come on, turn back. This is about as much fun as walking in a graveyard.
Jove, I'm sorry.
Sorry?
We're becalmed, and I forgot the oars at the landing.
Oh, nice going. So what do we do now? Camp out here in the middle of the ocean until the scouts come after us?
You have a delightful sense of humor.
I'm getting a chill that isn't so delightful.
I'm deucedly sorry. Here. Put my coat around you. Lovely.
The wind hasn't cooled you off any, has it? What was that?
What?
Did you hear it? Like a fish. You don't have whales in these parts, do you?
Whales? By Jove.
There it is again.
Yes, I heard it.
The water is so smooth.
Oh, the fish jumping, probably. Oh, this is cozy. They calmed at a very opportune time, if I might say so.
Yeah, I can't very well walk home, can I?
Anything for you.
You'll have your chance.
Anything.
Oh.
Now, what is it?
I thought I saw that rope up there at the bow, or whatever you call it, move.
Rope?
Yes, squirm sort of. Imagine that. I haven't had a drink in a week.
But there's no ropes at the bow.
Oh, yes, there is too.
Huh?
Charles.
It's no rope.
Then what is it?
I can't quite make out.
It is a rope. It is a rope. I tell you, it is.
I'm not quite sure.
Another one. Charles, look, another one. Came out of the water.
Oh.
Moving. Moving down along the deck. Charles, how can there be snakes out here?
Not snakes.
What's the matter with you? What are they? Look, there's two of them. Slimy.
There's another. Thick as a man's chest.
And another one.
Coming out of the water. Oh, no. It can't be. It can't.
What is it, Charles? What is it?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure none of us would mind a little time for breathtaking in this amazing story, Lord Marley's Guest. And now back to tonight's play, Lord Marley's Guest.
Hear it, Sam? Hear it?
Aye, I hear it. There's trouble out there.
But what, I'm asking?
Oh, I can't see. They're too far off. Too far off.
Oh, listen to her. Sam, it can't be...
What else in the devil's name can it be? The Lord forgive me. I should have warned him. Dirty pride or not, I should have warned him. I should have warned...
Fisherman!
Sam, it's her ladyship running this way.
The Lord help her. What can
fisherman.
She do for him?
Fisherman, help me. Please help
me. Lord help you, Mom. What can we do?
He's falling to us. What is can there, men? Get into your boats. We've got to get out there and help them.
Oh,
listen to him. Oh, help me in Mrs. name. Help me. All right,
come ahead, Mom.
Sam. Sam, have you lost your head? You're not going out there.
Step him forward, Mom. Watch your step.
Sam, you're balmy. It's the death out there.
Hand me that oar, Joe, and shove her off.
Sam, you can't be going out there. You was the one that warned us off. And now you're going out yourself. Sure, I'll shove you off. But I'm coming with you.
Good man, Joe.
Hurry.
That we will. Dig yours in deep, Joe.
Deep it is. The devil himself made you wait out there, but here we go to meet him. Faster, Sam. Go faster.
Back of me, Madeline. Stay back of me.
Horrible things reaching out. You've got to tell me what they are. What? Tell me.
Behind us. Look.
No, those snake things crawling toward me. I've got to keep my eyes on them. If I watch them, they can't hurt me. Yes, that's it.
Madeline.
If I watch them, they can't
Madeline,
hurt me.
Watch out.
Can they hurt
watch
me?
Out.
Can they?
What?
Answer me, you. Can they hurt me?
Yeah.
What are you staring like that for?
Now I know. I know what it is.
It?
Eight arms coming out of the water. The body must be beneath.
What are you talking about? What body?
It's body. There. Keel's shaking the boat. It's holding on with those horrible arms.
Arms? What are you raving about? Snakes?
No.
Slimy water snakes?
No, not snakes. I'd give my soul if there were. They're arms. It's arms.
Stop saying that.
It's arms. And it's waiting. Oh. Waiting underneath the sea for us. Oh. Waiting for us. Help. Help, somebody.
Charles.
Help.
Charles, what is it?
Help.
What? Tell me.
Devilfish.
No.
An octopus larger than the boat. Suckers on its tentacles.
Oh, my leg. One of those crawling things on my leg. Get it off. Get it off my leg.
I can't budge it. I can't budge it.
Oh, get it off.
Devil thing, you. Let's go of her. Let's go. Oh, my neck. No.
Frost, I beg you, Frost.
Sam, look. The boat is turned over.
Oh.
They're fighting. They're fighting something in the water.
No, we can't let them drown. No.
No, we can't. It's a devilfish.
I see it, too. Its arms, they're longer than the mast of the boat itself. The tide's taking us right into it. Get out your oars, Joe. We'll get out of there.
Yeah, we'll... Let go of my oars, Mom.
No. Get away. I won't let you turn back.
Let go of the oars, woman.
I won't let you turn back.
It'll kill us, too.
It's killing them. The octopus is killing them.
Not killing them. Playing with them like a cat with a mouse.
Oh, no.
Lifting them up in those great slimy arms and then dropping them back in the sea again. I held him under and drowned him.
Oh, no. Brought him up again. See?
Aye, but what?
Sam.
Oh, no.
What is it? What is that terrible thing that's lifting out of the water?
It's Ed, see? It's bringing the body toward its Ed. It's going to... No, don't look, Mom. No, he's dead anyways, Mom. Joe, let's get out of here. Come on, afford.
Wait. The woman. It's let her go. The woman.
Aye,
she's swimming for it. This way.
No, let's get out of here. Get the oars, man.
No, wait, Sam. Too late for him, but we can't leave her.
Right. We'll get you, miss.
She's too tired to swim anymore.
Stay afloat, miss.
Oh, hurry.
Come on, Sam. Put your back to that oar.
Aye.
We'll get you, miss. Bring her around, Sam. Grab her quick.
Aye, that I will. Got you now. Up you go. Up and in. That's it, Mom. That's it. In you go now.
You're safe now. You're safe.
Look. He's gone.
Eh?
The monster, the devilfish, gone. Under the water. Quick, put the girl down there in the bow and let's get out of here before he pulls us down.
Right.
It's all right. You're safe enough. You're safe, I tell you.
Safe. Safe.
Yes, yes, safe.
Safe.
Safe. Stop it. Stop it.
Safe.
No. Stop saying it.
Oh.
What is it? Why do you start? We've got to get ashore. The woman hysterical.
Sam, something is holding the boat back.
No, it can't be. We're almost at the beach and...
Look, look over the port side.
What?
The octopus. No.
It's underneath the water, holding us back.
Tentacle. Horrible black thing.
Come on, into the stern with us.
But she...
Another arm. I'll push it down. Beat it off with your oar, man. Oh, stay back, you fool.
Twisted the oar right out of my hand.
Look, another arm. And they're all moving up towards her.
She doesn't see it.
She thinks she's safe.
Around her neck, it's wrapping around.
Oh.
Dragged her over.
The boat's free.
Aye?
Free, I tell you, free. It's let go of us. We'll get away.
But why should that be? Dragged her over.
and let us go?
Aye. That's so. Picked her right out of the boat. And now the water's so calm and clear. And look, the sun's come out.
Huh? Aye. And his lordship and the blonde one dead? Dead under the sea. What say you, Mum?
Dead under the sea. Better so.
Well, Mr. Obler, all I've got to say is...
That brr is certainly an expressive one, Frank, but before we talk of brrs, I do want to thank June Dupre and Joseph Granby and Mary Jane Croft. And now, speaking of brrs, I think it reminds all of us that there's a strange, icy hand of retribution which apparently eventually seems to catch up with evildoers. Right at the moment, a man by the name of... what was it again? Oh, yes, Mussolini is remembering that. And now, Frank, after you've had a few words, I want to come back and tell our audience about a play which we're going to do next week. May I go on record right now as saying that I'm looking forward to next week's Lights Out with with more eagerness than I have to any play of this series.
And now, what's this about your eagerness over next week's play, Mr. Obler?
Well, a man can write a play with his tongue in his cheek or with his heart or with his mind. I'll say quite frankly, I wrote next week's play with heart and mind because it's a play that I wanted to do and I know you'll want to hear. It's not the usual lights-out play by any means. It's intended for even those in your family who may not be particularly interested in the mysterious and fantastic. So, have the entire family listening in, yes, children too, next week when we broadcast A Story of the Future. Your future.
Yes, tune in next Tuesday again for Arch Obler's Story of the Future. And if you need more vitamin B1 and iron, be sure to try ironized yeast. But remember, there's only one ironized yeast. You'll know it instantly by the yellow and orange package and by the big letters IY on the container and on each tablet.